Hi, this is Randy with Excel for Freelancers, and thanks for joining me today. We have a great, exciting lesson for you today where we're going to be shortening bit.ly links automatically and getting their click counts automatically. So please join us. Alrighty, thanks for joining me today. I've got a really cool training and tutorial for you today, as well, along with a free workbook that I'm going to send you when this is complete. Today's lesson is basically we want to use the extremely popular bit.ly link shortener to not only shorten our links automatically, but count how many times they have been clicked, and doing that all with Excel. If you're not familiar with bit.ly, it's a great link shortener, and basically what you do is you simply enter your long link here and it creates a short link for you, and then as well as it also tracks your clicks as well, so it's really really handy. And to do that, we just need to take a few steps. What bit.ly does require is an access token here, because we're using like the back end of bit.ly, so they do require us to use a bit.ly access token, and I'll walk you through that right now. I'm going to go ahead and log out of this test account, and I'm going to create a brand new one just so you can see how that's done. So we'll go ahead, in case you don't have a bit.ly link, let's go ahead and sign up. All right, and once you've signed up, you'll come to this screen here. Make sure you've also verified with your confirmation email. That's an important step. And then what you'll do is you'll come in to the settings up here on the right, and then click on the settings here, okay? And then click on advanced settings, okay? And what we want to do is we want to go to the API keys under, we use OAuth. OAuth is what we want to click on. So once we click on that, we want to first confirm our password. Okay. So we'll go ahead and do that. And then we'll click generate token. Okay. Once we have generated the token, we have an generate access token here. And that's great. And so what we want to do is we want to register an application. Okay. Register an application here, right up here. And then, so what we want to do is get the registration code. In order to do that, just click Get Registration Code. Okay, and we'll get that registration code in the email. So I'll pause this video and we'll get that right away. Okay, and once you've received that confirmation code here, we'll just go ahead and click on Complete Registration, and that'll complete it. Okay, now we have our registration code, and let's enter an application number. Let's call it Excel to bit.ly. But you can call it whatever you want. And then we want an application link. I'll go ahead and put in my website here, but you can put any website. And if you have a redirect link, you can put that in. That's not so important. Let's just go ahead and match it up because we won't be using that part, but please do put it in. And then we can leave the description blank. And then go ahead and click create your app. Okay. And what that's going to do is, oh, we do need a brief description. Okay, we'll go ahead and into that brief description. So I guess they want that. Okay, great. So now we have our client ID and client secret code. That's great. And what we want to do is we want to generate a token. So let's go ahead and put in our password for the account and then generate the token. And once we do that, it'll be generate token. All we need to do is copy this token here and paste that into our Excel file right here. Okay, now we're good to go. Okay, now we've got our code. Now we can start running this. And basically the idea is any URL we put in here, we want it shortened here. Okay, and then once we start getting clicks, we want to be able to click the count. So this is, first I'll show you how it's going to work, and then we'll go ahead and show that. So let's go ahead into an account here, my Excel for Freelancers group. Please join me if you haven't already. I'll make sure to include a link. Okay, so let's go ahead and put that link in there. And then we'll just paste that in there. It doesn't matter if it doesn't fit. And automatically the link's been shortened. Okay, let's go ahead and pull that out so you can see. So now it's been shortened. Now let's check that in our account. Okay, let's just go ahead and look at that in our bit.ly account so we can see how that looks. So let's go ahead and back to our bit.ly account. And we'll just click on the bit.ly, the main home screen, so we can go back to home. And here we see the link that we just created. Okay. And you see, this is the one we just created. So automatically, it's already in our bit.ly account. Okay, and let's go ahead and open this in a new tab. I'm just gonna open that shortcut and make sure it's working, and I wanna register a click. Okay, good, so it works great. Back into Excel. All right, so now we have the link, but now we've clicked on it once, so let's go ahead and update the counts. Okay, and now you see the click count is 1, so that worked great. Now let's look under the hood and see how all this works. All right, that's the exciting part for some of us. If you're not excited about it, then no problem, but it just works. I'll make sure to give you the details. Into the Visual Basic we go, the Developers tab, Visual Basic. You can also do Alt F11 if you do not have a Visual Developers tab. Just click under File, under Options, and then you'll go ahead into the Customize ribbon, and you'll want to make sure this Developer on the right side is clicked. Okay, so let's go ahead and see how this works. Into the Developers tab. Basically, what we have going on here is we just have really two types of macros. One is some on-sheet code, and we have also have the macro that runs our clicks. So let's start with the on-sheet one. And basically, what I want to happen here, okay, is that when I enter a URL here in this column, column B6 through as far as you want to go, I want it to look at that information, and I want it to put the bit link right here. That's all I want to happen. We enter a link here, the bit.ly link is added here and generated. Okay, so let's go ahead and see how that works. All right, and here we can, basically what we've done in this is I've dimmed the object. This is basically the object HTTP, and that basically is the way that we go and get the information from bit.ly. We tell it, hey, here's a link, and then it returns back our short link. And that's all that's basically going on. And this is what JSON is, JSON, the URL, and that basically helps us. We've dimmed these as all strings because we need to use those strings during this, okay? This particular line lets us know, hey, if there's any change, remember, we're on worksheet change, right? Worksheet change. If there's any change between B6 and B100, you can put this as many rows as you want. If you want to create 1,000, you can. If there's any change, then do something, okay? So that's what that not intersect is for. This one is to handle errors. Often when you have a change and you highlight a lot of errors, a lot of cells, you're going to get a bug. So basically this line says if the target count, that means if the target is greater than 1, if the user has selected more than 1 cells or changed, in this case, more than 1 cells, then just exit the sub. Please don't count it. You know, we're only focused on working on 1 cell at a time here, okay? Also, if the target value is empty, also exit the sub. That means if I go in here, right, and I double click in here and I make a change, but I just hit enter, right, then just go ahead and exit. In other words, they haven't entered a link, so we really don't want anything to happen. Okay, so that's the target value. And next, what we want to do is we want to define that account token, right? The account token, this is a string. Remember, we've defined it up here as a string. Sheet 1, C4 value, okay? C4 value, okay? We also want to make sure that the user has entered that string. So our next line of code is if at the account token equals nothing, double quotes, then message doc, please enter your bit.ly access token to get started, okay? And then it just says watch the YouTube video for details in case you need help. And I'll make sure to include a link to the YouTube video so you can watch this over and over again. If you're watching it on Facebook, you can also watch it on YouTube. Okay, and then it exits the sub, so it doesn't do anything. So we just need to make sure there's a few things that are required before we go ahead and take care of it, okay? And now we've defined our long URL. Our long URL is the target value. That's the value that they've just added, okay? And then our next line of code is basically, you know, URLs, they can't really use certain characters like spaces, certain characters like stars, or, you know, specific characters. So they're often replaced, okay? So they're often replaced with different characters. For example, like if it's a backslash, it's replaced with %2f. And that's the reason bit.ly can only read certain characters, okay? So this line replaces all of those characters that are important. There's actually more characters, and I'm gonna include a link to that for you on Wikipedia here, right? Here is a Wikipedia, and this basically says all of these characters, and here's the replacement. So it's kind of, so you can see the reserved characters after percent, these are encoding. So the colon becomes percent 3A, the backslash. So I've included some of the more popular ones. You may want to add them all under the replace. So basically it says, if there's an and, replace it with percent 26. So that's the idea there, okay? And so we'll continue on with that. Next, so that's why we're doing all that replace, replace, replace. So that's just, that's the reason it does it. The next, what we're going to do is we're going to set the object of HTTP to create object. Basically, this allows us to create that JSON file that's going to allow us to go and get that URL shortener. It's going to send our URL, and it's going to return back a shorter URL directly from Bitly. Bitly allows this. Bitly encourages this. So they've created this for us. So it's a very nice thing. And then what we're going to do is we're going to define the URL, the entire URL. Remember, we're sending our URL is here, right? Long URL. But we have to send more things to Bitly. We need to know what the access token is. We need to know what format it is. So I've done all that for you. And basically, Bitly says, hey, if you want to get a short access code, and remember, we're looking to shorten here, okay? So what are we asking for? We're asking for it to shorten. What token we're using? We're using this account access token or account token. And what are we going to shorten? We're going to shorten this long URL. So basically, all that comes is combined into one entire URL. Okay, and then what we want to do is we're going to open it and we're going to get. What do we want to get? We want to get the shorter URL. So basically, these three lines basically send it directly to Bitly and it returns a short link. So all we're doing is saying, okay, now we've got the response here. The response is our shorter link, and that's result. Okay, and we actually can move this line, and then what we're saying is range C and the target row, basically the same row that we've just created, except we're doing C. What do we want there? We want the result. And the reason this left is Bitly was returning, it looked like a carriage return, or like looked like two rows. So I just included, basically I took off the last character because the last character was like a return. It looked like, and it was doubling up the line, so this is more of a clean, more of a cleaner result. So that's it. That's all that's happening there. Okay. And so then the only other macro that we're running is we're counting clicks. Okay. And that's under count clicks. And here basically we're going to, we've dimensioned all the same things. We're also going to need the access token. We've also checked to make sure it's working. We've also, here we've defined the last row, because in this case, what I want to do is I want to start here and I want to go through all the links, you know, and I want to, actually, I'm going to go through row C, because if you have existing Bitly shortened links, they're already shortened, just put them here, okay? Put them all here. You may be able to download it through Bitly. You don't need to actually shorten them first. You could actually put links that have already been shortened. If you have an account and you've been shortening them for a long time, you could put them here, right? And then so what this code is going to do is going to start in row 6, going to find the last row. What is the last row of the shortest link? And then it's going to go through each one and then get it a count. Okay, so that's the idea. So we do need to define the last row, which is what I've done. The last row is C999 up. So this helps us know what the last row of column C is. Even if there's no long URL in column B, that's fine. So what I've done is saying, okay, for the current row 6, because that's our first row of the table to the last row, I want you to go through in each one. If C is empty, okay, if C is not empty, please continue with this. If C is empty, just continue. We don't want to shorten any URL that doesn't exist. So first, we're going to say, okay, what is that short URL? And it's this value of C under the current row. And then all we're going to do the replace again, because we generally, Bitly should not, this may not be required. It's like an extra careful step. Bitly, but if you have links that you've customized, you may have included one of those characters that it cannot be read. So I've just added it here just as a safe keeping. And then again, what we're doing is here we're getting, but this time we want clicks. Here's the difference. Clicks. Remember, before it was a short shortener. Okay, so now we want clicks. We've also had access token and the short URL. Here we put in the short URL. We basically want to say send to billing says with this URL, how many clicks has there been? Okay, and all we're doing is returning that value in row D. Okay, that's it. Okay, so that's pretty much it. It's a super simple training today. I wanted you guys to have it. I'm going to actually use this myself because I use Bitly constantly. I'll make sure that there's a tutorial attached to this, but it'll be this tutorial in case you've gotten the workbook and you want to re-see it again. But basically, you can just click update accounts and it's going to update. If you've liked this video, please like it and share it. I do appreciate that. And if you have not already, please join our Excel for Freelancers group where I personally will be answering your questions as well as some amazing group members. And it's becoming an amazing group. So thank you very much and we'll see you soon.